with a brand new video. Today we are going to unbox a new product from Wonder Chef, and along with me today I have my wife Clara Fernandez as well in this video, who is going to show us how effective the Wonder Chef Turbo Chopper is. So let's go and unbox the product right away. Okay, this is a box that has arrived from Wonder Chef. I have purchased the Wonder Chef Turbo Chopper from Amazon, and this is the parcel here. We are gonna go ahead and unbox this parcel. I haven't opened it right now, but previously I have used other small choppers and they were quite useful in the kitchen. Clara has been using it for over a year. She has used the Prestige chopper, which was a small chopper but very useful and very powerful in cuttings vegetables and mincing onions and stuff for curries. So, and she wanted to go one step ahead, and that's the reason we chose to go with the Wonder Chef Turbo Chopper. So let's see how this one is, and we are just gonna unbox this product. So Clara, can you just help me unbox this? So yeah, you know, Clara is just cutting the box open with a pair of scissors. And here it is. So we have just unboxed the outer packing of Wonder Chef. So again, let me just remind you guys that I purchased this from Amazon, and this is the actual box of the Wonder Chef Turbo Chopper. So let's look at the packaging first of all. It came in a very neat cardboard box. So this was the packaging first. Also on the main packaging, the outer packaging that came, it had the Wonder Chef branding on it and the Amazon tape, of course, because I had ordered it from Amazon. So they sent it in a very safe packaging here. Coming to the main content of the box, this is the main box of the Wonder Chef Turbo Chopper. So what do we have here? First of all, we have the Wonder Chef branding here. It is the India's most admired brand, and it has won this award in 2019, if you can see this. The most admired brand of India, India's choice. Okay, this is a brand by Sanjeev Kapoor, one of the top chefs in India. So you can see his photo here as well, and there is mentioned that there's a 1 year warranty for this product as well. So yeah, so this is the box here, and in the front face of the box they have shown the product itself, the Wonder Chef Turbo Chopper here, along with the different attachments that come with this Turbo Chopper. Along with that, they have shown that this can also be used to do knead dough for chapatis and rotis as well. So I'm really looking forward to this product. So let's go ahead and see what else is there on the packaging itself. So on top of the box we can see again the Wonder Chef branding here. Wonder Chef, cook with pride is their tagline. Then Turbo Chopper is a product with dough kneader attachment. So this specific box has a dough kneader attachment as well. Other products from Wonder Chef have been mentioned here, like cooktops and chimneys, blenders, grinders and tandoors, pressure cookers, and non-stick cookware is also available from Wonder Chef. So this is their product line, which is all available online and you can easily purchase it online. So this is on top of the box. Moving on the sides of the box, on side of the box we have again the Wonder Chef branding here, the product name, the Turbo Chopper with dough kneader attachment, and then there's a bit of an introduction. So, and then it says that it's a dual speed, first gear for power and fourth for speed. So it's a dual speed chopper here. It's a make in India product, made in India. So, and the MRP of the product given here is 2000. I think I purchased it for around 1140 on Amazon, but the MRP of the product given here is rupees 2000. It's a made in India product, a make in India initiative, And then here it is given the net quantity, which is 1 unit, and month and year of manufacturing is Jan 2021, and then the barcode is here. So yeah, moving on to the back side is the same thing that we saw on the face. Okay, also a nice thing here is there is a QR code here which you can scan for how to use video. So you can actually see how to use it by scanning the QR code itself. So there's no CD or something giving inside to know how to use this product. Moving on to the other side, we have here is again the Turbo Chopper, the Wonder Chef branding on top, the tagline "Cook with Pride," and now they have shown you the different parts of the product here. There's a knob on top, an arm, plunge, low speed gear, high speed gear, top cabinet, blade holder, chopping blades, whip blade, thin and thick inserts, slicing platform, julienne blades, handle, bowls, non-slip foot. Okay, and the new thing that you get here with this box here is a new dough blade for kneading dough hygienically and conveniently. And then on the right hand side, I mentioned that there are two gears. One is a low speed gear, which is the first gear, which gives you more power in chopping, but the speed is slow. And once you have like roughly chopped using the first gear, then you move on to the fourth gear and it will give you high speed chopping. So yeah, this is the outer packaging of the product. Let's move ahead to the product. So we'll quickly go and unbox this product. So yeah, so we'll just open the box. Okay, can Claire help me with it? Okay, let's see. So this is a box, we have just unboxed it, and it has, it is here, we can see it has come in a plastic bag here. And anything else inside? Okay, that is apart from the product, we have the warranty card here from Wonder Chef. So there's a warranty card, so we'll keep it back in the box. We'll keep the box aside for now. Let's see what all do we have here. The first thing, then let's remove the plastic on the product. Okay. So I'll just segregate everything and just keep it here so that you can see what all has come. Okay, these are the different contents of the box after unboxing it. So this is the main container jar. You all can see it's made of toughened plastic. So very good quality of plastic here, and it has a rubber ring at the base so that it gives you a good grip. So you can see it doesn't move when I'm trying to push it, so it doesn't slip around when you're using the product. The next thing that we have here is the lid of the Wonder Chef Turbo Chopper, which goes right on top of this. Then we have the handle, but to use, which we are going to use to turn and chop the vegetables. Then this is the handlebar for the container, which goes in here, right? So this is the one, another part that we have here. And then this is a thing which we can use to push the vegetables inside. So this part goes in here. So I'll assemble it and show you all, so don't worry about that. Now coming to the attachments that come along with this. So first of all, here is a whipping attachment, which is used to whip cream, milk, buttermilk, lassi. You can use this attachment when you want to make milkshakes, lassi, buttermilk, etc. You'll use this attachment. This is the main chopping attachment here, the chopping blade, like really big chopping blades you can see here. These might be like more than 2-2.5 inch long blades. So three sharp blades that we have, really sharp blades. You can see that it's really sharp. So be careful while handling it, and especially while trying to clean it. Next here is the slicing disc, So this is a slicing disc. You can see it comes with a sharp blade here as well. There's a sharp blade here. And then this is a the thickness for the thickness thickness controller. Basically, if you want fine slices, you put this attachment into place. If you want thick slices, you remove this attachment and then it will give you thick slices. So you can see then it's a thick slicer available here. So yeah. So if you want fine slices like for potato chips, then you put this thing back into its place so that you get a fine slice. Apart from that, here we have the julienne cutters. So you just need to push it up like this and just turn it around and cut it back, and then instead of chips it will give you juliennes. So you can see this, there are sharp blades on it which will help to cut juliennes. And again, in this, if you want more finer, then you twist, put in the other one as well. So there are two julienne cutters. So if you put both the blades, it will give you the fine juliennes. So we will show you everything, like how to use it to make various things. We'll show it to you all. But I'm just showing you all the parts right now. What do you all get with this product, right? So this is the slicing disc. Then coming to the new addition to this product is a kneading blade here. So it's not a kneading attachment. So it's not a blade, but a plastic blade here, like a plastic thing which will help to knead the dough. So this will help you to knead the dough. So these are the four different attachments that you get with the Wonder Chef. So now let's go ahead and let's get it assembled. So first thing that I'm going to put is the handle for the main jar here. So I'm going to attach the handle itself. So you can see there's a push button here which you need to pull like this. So I pull the button, and here if you can see there are grooves into which this handlebar goes. So you just need to pull the button and just push it up till you hear the click sound. So our handlebar is in place so that we can easily grip the jar. Next thing that we are going to do is we'll be putting in the chopping blade so that we can chop a few onions right now. So I want to chop a few onions, so I'm going to put in the chopping blade. So this blade can be used to chop onions, cabbage, tomatoes, what name it, and you can chop it in this. Like in the earlier chopper that I had of Prestige, I even used to chop and like mince chicken in it, and it really worked well for a year, and then it broke because I really used it for extreme things like chopping meat and stuff. So yeah, so but definitely for vegetable this thing is going to be amazing. You can definitely use it to chop vegetables. So I put in the chopping blade. The next thing I'm going to do is I'm going to put in the lid. So this is the gear that goes into the main blade, and then you just need to twist it so that it locks into place. So now my lid has locked into place. Now here is the knob. The knob will go in the first gear to start off with, and this is the pushing thing that we have. So this is specially used when you're using it for the slicing part, wherein you can push the, say you're doing potato chips, you push the potato halfway in, and once you're halfway in, then you use this to push it further and to completely use it. So this is how it moves. So you can see when I'm turning this, the blades are turning, and this is the first gear, so it will move at the speed of which I'm moving my hand. Once I have like broadly chopped things up, then I remove the knob from the first gear and I put it in the fourth gear, and see this, how effortlessly it is spinning so fast. Four times the speed when I use the fourth gear. So start off, you need to start at the first gear. So let's unlock this cap again. And let's test the chopping power of this WonderChef Turbo Chopper. So to start off, we are going to use a few onions to chop. We are going to take a few onions. We'll just cut the onions into halves and put it into the jar right now. So Clara, can you just put in some onions here? And here, so Clara is chopping the onions, just slicing them into halves and adding it to the jar. And we will be taking her review for itself, like to know how easy her work has been, how easy this product is going to make her work in the kitchen, like how quickly she will be able to make things. So let's see, like let's take her review on the scene. So Clara, how many onions are you adding here?
5.
So Clara is adding in 5 onions at a time to chop. So yeah, so she has added 5 onions now. The next thing, Clara, you just need to put on the lid. So let's see. Yeah. Just put it into place. And now just okay. So now that the lid is into place, all you need to do now is chop the onions very quickly. So you can see that the onions are in place, the blades are there, and now we are just going to quickly chop it. You see now Clara is just quickly chopping it. And you can see how effortlessly she is doing it right now. And once the onions are roughly chopped, you can see that they are getting roughly chopped right now. Now you will move it to the fourth gear. Now that they are roughly chopped, let's move it to the fourth gear. So you just need to remove the knob. Just pull it out and put it into the fourth gear. And now it's going to be in the fourth gear. So you can see how finely this onion is chopped. So I can show it to you all here. You can see how finely. If you want it to be more fine, so you just need to chop it for some more time now. Yeah, now Clara is chopping it again. And the onion is almost minced. So is this enough, Clara, for you? So let's go and see the consistency of the onion that has been chopped. Let's see how finely this thing has been chopped. So let's go and open the jar. We just need to twist it open. And so come and let's see how fine this onion has been chopped. Look at it, so fine right now. So really mince the onion, like you can like chop it for some lesser time and I think it would be fine, but if you really chop it a lot, then it becomes like a mince. So very fine chopping here, and like I think less than a minute, we chopped 5 onions here. So that is the speed of the turbo chopper. So just imagine how much time you are going to save in while cooking anything, like whenever you need to chop something. Look at this consistency. Everything has been so finely chopped and in one consistency, like there aren't any big pieces of onion. Everything is of the same size, chopped very evenly. So this is really amazing. I'm amazed by the power of the WonderChef Turbo Chopper. Really amazed with it. Now the next thing that we are going to do is, now that you all know how amazing this is to chop things, let's go and see the slicing blades. So the first thing that we are going to do is we are going to take out potato chips. So the first thing that we are going to try is to chop some potato chips. So we are going to chop some potato chips right now. We are going to show you, like we'll just take one potato and see how many chips do we get from it. So to make potato chips, we just need to put in the slicing You don't need to clean it, very nice. Mm-hmm. You just saw how amazingly and finely it chopped the onions so quickly. Within a minute, we just chopped like 5 onions. We just minced it right now, which Clara needed to make cutlets. So we just minced the onions in under a minute. The next thing that we are going to do is we are going to use the slicing blade. We are going to use the slicing blade to make potato chips. So we are going to put in the blade here. Like, you need to carry it with one finger. Like, just insert your finger inside the hole and carry it and place it on the holder. So now that the slicing blade is in place, the next thing you do is you put on the lid and you lock it. Okay. Now you need to put on the knob into the first gear. Okay. And then you need to insert the potato from here. You need to insert the potato from here. And then you just need to turn the handle. So we have inserted the potato here. We'll catch the potato with 2 fingers here. Here we are going to catch the potato with 2 fingers here. And then we are just going to turn the handle, and you can see that the slices are coming out. When we reach like half the potato, we are going to put the holder into place like this, so that it holds the potato down, and we'll continue to chop. So now we have put in the holder into place, and now we are slicing the potatoes. The slicing is giving a bit of a problem, you can see here. The slicing blade is keeps coming out. The fine slicer blade is the attachment for the fine slicer is coming out every time we are trying to slice potatoes. So I don't know if it is a problem with the product or is it just the product that I have purchased. So this this attachment keeps popping out every time. So one negative point here, that this is popping out. But talking about the slices, it has come very fine and nice and perfect for potato chips. You can see here, like, perfectly fine slices here we have, which are perfect for potato chips. Like, it really didn't take any time to get these slices, and like perfectly fine slices out here. So apart from this issue of fine slicing, the attachment coming out from time to time, I think it is doing the job pretty well. So now we have removed the fine slicing attachment, and again we are going to do some large potato chop, potato slices right now, and we are going to see how well does that work. First, let me just remove the potato slices, chips that I have chopped, and then we'll move on to that. Now I'm attaching the slicing blade again, slicing disc and the cover, and again I'm going to put in the potato this time. And now we are going to chop it. And now we have got larger potato slices, which are perfect for like a biryani and just to have potato slices fried. So you can see these are large, thick slices of potato when you compare to this, which is a potato chip. Look how fine this is. And this is with a large blade, and this is with the fine blade. So the large blade worked really well, but the fine blade, the attachment kept popping up, and like it gave trouble when trying to slice it. So yeah, so one negative that the popping in this attachment keeps coming out when you're trying to do potato chips, but without this attachment it was working absolutely fine. So here we have broad potato slices here. If you want to make fried potatoes finely recipe, you can easily do that. And look at the amount of wasted. Just one slice of potato gets wasted here. And you have got so many amazing slices of potatoes there. Like within a minute you have like chopped one potato down into such fine slices. The next attachment that I'm going to show you all is a Julienne attachment. So you can see the Julienne attachment here. So you just need to push this attachment out and you can see that there are Julienne blades here. So you just put this into place again, upside down, and the Julienne blades are in place. So for that I'm going to use a carrot. So let me just get a carrot here. Clara, can you just pass me a carrot?
Yes, I do.
So again, we are going to put in the slicing blade. And now, we'll put the lid back on. Okay, and then we are going to put the carrot inside. So, we'll just put a piece of carrot inside here. And then we'll... So you can see the Julienne's coming down. Now I'll just push it down with the holder. And here we have like thick Julienne's of carrots, chopped and ready to serve in a salad. Let's look at the wastage here, like how much of the carrot is wasted. So quite a bit of the carrot got wasted here. Now let's go ahead and look at the Julienne's that we have got here. So we have got perfectly fine Julienne's made here out of carrot. So you can see this. So lovely and nice. And again, within a minute, like it really didn't take time to do this, to get these Julienne's out. The next attachment that we have is a fine Julienne attachment. So if we put the second blade also upside down, it will give us a fine Julienne's, fine carrot Julienne's you can make out of it. So let's quickly try that one as well. So again, I'm going to put the, this is the second Julienne blade. So I'm just going to put this as well upside down for more finer Julienne's. Okay, we'll just remove this piece of carrot from here. And again, I'm just going to put my finger in and put it back into place. And again, we are going to take another carrot. So here, another piece of carrot I'm going to take. I'm going to place it in, put down the holder on it, and start chopping it. And let's see the Julienne that we have got right now. Again, quite a bit of wastage again here. So you can see two big pieces of carrots have been wasted again. So out of two carrots, we just wasted so much carrot here when we tried making Julienne's out of it. So here, so let's look at the fine Julienne's that we have here. So you can see here, the fine Julienne's here that are cut. Now if you want very thin and fine, very fine Julienne's, you can put this attachment as well. And then it will give you very fine, like the potato chips, in that shape the Julienne's. So yeah, this was a Julienne attachment that we had here. Next thing I'm going to show you, I'm going to chop a cucumber, which I need for salad. So I'm going to chop a cucumber into rounds and show you how effective this chopper is in chopping cucumber. So while using the Julienne blades and the slicing disc, really be very careful because these blades are very, very sharp and they can hurt you. So be very, very careful while using it. And make sure you all keep it away from children. So now we are going to try to chop some cucumber. So again, I put in the slicing disc for our slices. And now we are going to get a cucumber and try to slice a cucumber. So here we have cucumber here. So we are going to try and slice the cucumber. So first of all, let's put the cucumber here. You can see how easily it's going to chop the slices. And now we are going to use the pressing attachment here. And here we are done. So again, a bit of wastage here. You can see that a little bit of cucumber is wasted again here. This piece of cucumber is wasted. Now let's look at the results that we have here. So here we have really nice and round slices of cucumber cut. Really amazing. Very well cut cucumber here. Like I cut such a huge cucumber in under a minute, I think below 30 seconds right now. So I'm going to just remove it on a plate again. Keep it at the side. So this turbo chopper does the chopping work quite well. I'm going to show you all how to knead dough in the Wonder Chef turbo chopper. So for that, first we need to take the dough kneading attachment here. We are just going to place the dough kneading attachment here. You can see this. And now I'm going to put in the dough that I need to knead. So here is 1 cup of dough. I'll remove the. We are going to put 1 cup of dough here. Slowly we'll put the dough in. So we have put in 1 cup of dough. Just remove it off the plate. We have 1 cup of dough here. And now I'm going to put the lid on top. And I'm going to put it into place and lock the lid. Now the lid is locked. Okay. So while kneading the dough, you need to start off with the fourth gear. You can start off with the fourth gear and then slowly add in oil and water. So first thing that I'm going to add is some water. So here I have a bottle of water. So I'm going to add in a bottle of water right now. So we added some water. So with practice, you all will come to know exactly how much water is needed to knead the dough. And you can see the dough forming into like flaky dough forming in. And as you start feeling the pressure to move the gear, change into first gear and start spinning it so that it will easily start binding the dough together. So if you can see it, you can see this, the dough is starting to bind together here. Slowly we can see that the dough is binding together. With very little effort, that is. So you can see that Lara is applying very little effort here to bind the dough together. At this point, we'll just add some oil as well. So we'll add in some oil from the same place here. We're going to add in some oil, a tablespoon of oil. We can see that the dough is You can see that the dough is forming right now. Like a ball of dough is being formed and it is coming off the sides. So we'll just add in a little bit of more water here. You see how easily Clara is doing it. I think the dough is already ready. It is already kneaded nicely and hygienically. And it's already ready right now. It has come off the sides. So I think we can open the jar and check the dough once. Now we'll just unlock the jar. So we'll quickly just unlock the jar right now and we'll check on the dough. You can see how nicely the dough has come together. So as you'll use it, you all will come to know the consistency of the dough that you'll require. And if it is too sticky, you all can actually add in some more flour. So guys, you can see that the dough has formed a ball. Now we'll just quickly open the lid and let's see how the dough has formed. Here you all can see it has formed so nicely here, so easily. Under 2 minutes I think the dough has been formed and so hygienically done without any pressing from the hands and stuff. So yeah, I think this is an amazing product for kneading dough. It has kneaded the dough quite well and soft. I can't wait to have the chapatis made from this dough right now. So yeah, so this was the kneading attachment. And you can see that there's almost no wastage of dough here. It has all come out into one big bowl of dough. So yeah, very well kneaded. The dough is very well kneaded. We'll just keep the dough aside. So yeah, this was the last attachment which I wanted to show you, which was a dough kneading attachment. Just rounding off my video with all the attachments that I have got here. First of all, this is a dough kneading attachment. Then we have the whipping attachment which can be used for lassis and buttermilk. Then we have the slicing attachment here with the julienne blades along with it, and lastly the main 3-blade attachment, which is a chopping blade. The main attachment that is there, the chopping blade, it sits right here to chop any vegetables, onions, tomatoes, potatoes, name it, and this wonderful turbo chopper can easily chop it. So guys, I really like this product. It has eased out a lot of the kitchen work. I feel this will ease out a lot of Clara's kitchen work. Clara, what is your review? How do you find this product? Like, is it helpful? Like, do you think it makes sense?
Yes, it's very helpful. I like the product and it will save our time.
So you all heard it from her. It is really gonna save a lot of her time in the kitchen. So guys, this is the Wonder Chef Turbo Chopper. If you all have used this product, do let me know your views on the same in the comment section below. If you all have liked this video, don't forget to hit the like button and do subscribe to our channel for more such amazing product videos.